far enough away that they weren't likely to bump into anyone from there, but close enough for Ice Abel's parents to make the journey at Christmas, in the years before they died. Tom and Ralph wrote to each other once in a while. Just a greeting, short, plain, but deeply felt all the same. Ralph's daughter and her family had moved into his little cottage after Hilda died, and looked after him well, though his health was frail these days. When Bluey married Kitty Kelly, Tom and Isabel sent a gift, but they didn't attend the wedding. Neither of them ever returned to Portageuse. And the best part of 20 years flowed past like a quiet country river, deepening its path with time. The clock chimes. Almost time to leave. It's a short drive to town these days, with the sealed roads. Not like when they first arrived. As Tom ties his tie, a stranger with gray hair catches a glimpse of him, just a flick of an eye, then he remembers it's himself in the mirror. Now, the suit hangs more loosely on his frame, and there is a gap between the collar and the neck inside it. Through the window, the waves rise, sacrificing themselves in a blizzard of white, far out to sea. The ocean gives not the slightest hint that any time has passed, ever. The only sound is the buffeting of the August gales. Having placed the envelope in the camphor chest, Tom closes the lid reverently. Soon enough, the contents will lose all meaning, like the lost language of the trenches, so imprisoned in the time. Years bleach away the sense of things until our thoughts,